introduce
Sir,
yourself.
Sir, my name is Vasikaran. I am a Christian. And we are told that the Crusaders and the Crusades were waging a holy war. I am a Christian, sir. I am a journalist. We were told that the Crusaders and the Crusades were waging a holy war. And now after seeing the films, we know how much terrorism they did to the innocent Muslims. And do you not think that this religious terrorism started from these Crusades? And it is in another way, it continues against the Muslims through all these centuries. Now this terrorism seems to be in another phase, and why these Westerners are always, after the Crusades, continuing this sort of thing against
The brother asked a very good question. He being a Christian, he says that he was told that the Crusades were holy war, and that's what I told you. The Orientalists used this word, holy war, for jihad. It was nothing but the usage of holy war was another name for crusade, to see to it that everyone joins and think it's religious. And the brother, being a journalist, has rightly said that now we realize that these crusades were nothing but terrorizing the innocent Muslims. I didn't say anything about this in my talk because I came here to speak about the Islamic concept. I didn't touch on any religion, negative point of any religion, neither do I want to touch. It is just, I said that all religion prescribe fighting to let peace prevail. That's what everyone does. I never touched on any religion. That's not what I've come here for. But if you ask me a question, I have to say, yes, you're right, brother, that the crusade did terrorize the innocent Muslims. And that's how it has continued. And now, the same thing what they do, they are now saying the same thing to the Muslims, which if you analyze, you see in the world around you. You see in the world around you that how many people are actually accepting it. Today, Islam is the fastest growing religion in the world. There may be still incidences somewhere in the world. There are black sheep in every community. But you will not be able to point out as a whole that where in the world are people forcing other non-Muslims to accept Islam at the point of the sword. No way. In fact, they are getting harassed because they are Muslims. Now, this thing can only be solved if you go back. If you go back to the Bible. If you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 40-41, he says that if anyone strikes you on the right cheek, offer him the other. If anyone strikes you on the right cheek, offer him the other. If someone asks you to walk 1 mile, you walk with him twain. If someone asks for the shirt, you give him the cloak. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, a messenger of Almighty God, he shows us how peace should prevail. He says, love your neighbor. So if you analyze, if you go back to the scripture, I don't find any way where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself prescribed that you should harass the Muslims. So therefore I tell all the human beings that go back the scripture which you consider to be the most holiest, whichever scripture you consider, at least go back to your scripture, as the Quran says in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 64, تَعَلَوْا إِلَىٰ قَلْمِتِنْ سَوَىٰ إِمْ بَيْنَنَا بَيْنَكُمْ. Come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah, na'budu illallah. That we worship none but Allah. Hope that answers the question.